Hello, everybody! This is Punk Demon Neo, previously known as Ultimate Lifeform RB, and welcome to a brand new playthrough from my channel featuring Splatoon. This game was originally released in 2015 for the Wii U, and it is my choice for my next weekend exclusive playthrough. So when you first start the game, you're presented with this character creation screen, and our Inkling is going to be a boy. And let's go ahead and pick his skin tone and his eye color. Pretty simple, and let's go ahead and go with these changes and let's dive in with a tutorial. Hey you! Yeah, you! Wanna be the freshest squid on the block? We'll teach you some funky fresh moves on the way to Inkopolis! And now things are going to be a little awkward for this tutorial because this game utilizes the Wii U's gamepad as well as the gyroscopic motion controls in order to move around and control your vision. Luckily, you can turn off the gyroscopic motion controls, which I am going to do when given the opportunity. Not the biggest fan of that, but it takes a little getting used to, but once you get it down, it's not that bad. And like I said, you can turn it off, unlike a certain other high-profile Wii U game, which I will not name. So you can reset the camera with Y and other things. You shoot ink using the ZR. You move with the left thumbstick, and you can go into a squid. You can turn into a squid with ZL. And doing this, you can swim around in the ink that you lay down through your gun. And you can also refill your ink by swimming around in the ink. Now let's see if I can get this to work. This is very awkward, ladies and gentlemen. So yeah, this is gonna be my next weekend exclusive playthrough as we go through the remainder of this tutorial. And it's kind of funny since last weekend I finished Unreal Championship for the Xbox, and now we're going into another shooting game. But this is a much different animal from Unreal Championship. This is very much a different game. And it's a very fun game, too. This is definitely one of my favorites from the Wii U. Although, like I said, in terms of controls and stuff, it did take some getting used to in terms of being able to really play it. So let's keep on going here. We pretty much got most of the controls laid out pretty nicely. Now we can throw bombs with R, which can be very helpful for clearing out certain enemies and obstacles, and swim up the wall. You can do a lot by going into squid form and swimming around in the ink that you lay down. Okay, that's gonna do it for the tutorial. Let's get to the main part of the game. Alrighty then, welcome to Inkopolis. This is the plaza where all the freshest folk come to chill like krill. Most Inklings here are obsessed with the hottest sport in Inkopolis, ink battles. The crazy tall building in front of you is Inkopolis Tower. It's the city's most famous landmark. There's a lobby in the first floor of Inkopolis Tower for online battles. This is the Booyah Base, a shopping mall for all your Inkling needs. You can buy all kinds of fresh gear and weapons to use in battle. But check it, the staff in the shops can be a snobby bunch. They won't serve you if they don't think you're fresh enough. Battle Dojo is on the second floor of that building over there. Check it out if you want to battle your friends one-on-one and sharpen your skills. You might want to steer clear of that back alley. Smells a little fishy. And next we have... Huh? Who's that creepy old dude? He seems like the type who could get you mixed up in something dangerous. Whatever. Why don't you first just head to the lobby in Inkopolis Tower? That's where you can get your splat on. Alright, so the first thing that I am going to do, bear with me please, is I am going to turn off motion controls. That's a lot better. Now I can just use the thumbsticks. Thank goodness they have that option, because the I'm one of those people where the gyroscopic controls, I just cannot get used to them. I gotta be able to have those as an optional feature. But yes, here is basically your central hub of Splatoon. And Splatoon is primarily a multiplayer-based shooter. So the big focus of the game is the multiplayer in Inkopolis Tower, the online battles and such. However, we're actually pretty interested in what this old dude over here has for us, and let's go ahead and enter this area here, and let's see what's up. The Octarians are coming! No! Hi. I guess I lost my cool for a minute there. I'm Captain Cuttlefish, leader of the legendary Squid Beak Splatoon. That look in your eye, it's the look I've been looking for. The great Zapfish that powers Inkopolis has been squidnapped. Nobody believes me, but it's the work of the Octarians, I just know it. They want revenge for the great turf war of 100 years ago. I've been keeping an eye on them this whole time, of course. But they stole the great Zapfish right from under my nose. Please, you gotta help me rescue the great Zapfish. So, I'm gonna take your silence as a yes. Starting today, you are Agent 3 of the new Squid Beak Splatoon. This is your brand new hero suit. It'll help you fight the Octarians. What a great fit for a hand-me-down from Agents 1 and 2. Now let's go get those Octo jerks. I'm counting on you, bucko. So yes, Captain Cuttlefish here has given us our task, and this is essentially the single-player campaign of Splatoon. It's not very long. There are 27 stages in the single player campaign, but it is a nice introduction to the game, and it will help you get down the skills that you will ultimately need if you want to play the multiplayer. So let's go ahead and actually reveal the level entrances here. The level entrances are these little kettles. At first, the kettles are invisible, but if you spray them with your ink, they will become they will be revealed. Now let's make our way back to the first kettle. We're gonna do all these levels in order. And level one is Octo Trooper Hideout. Catch that Zapfish. Here we go. So the plot obviously isn't much. The great Zapfish has been captured and we have to rescue it. Give him heck, Agent 3! So here we go! Let's get into the actual gameplay here, and here we have the Octo Troopers. They are basically your standard mooks for the single player. They don't take that much to kill, but you want to be careful because they can launch their own type of ink as well, and it will damage you. And, try to avoid the ink as much as possible and cover it up with your own. Now, some Octo Troopers like this have a shield. You can't really get past their shields, and as Captain Cuttlefish lays out, we can basically sneak around our enemies by hiding in our ink, which allows us to do this. Get the drop on them by sneaking around and shooting them from behind. And off to the next area, using our super jump. Alright, this one we're gonna have to do some work. Don't overdo it, bucko. Hide behind a wall if you're hurt. That is one thing you're gonna have to really, I guess you could say master or learn, is that you gotta be able to know when to back off from an enemy engagement. If you feel like, you know, you gotta be able to know, I don't know how to put it, you know, it's like in any other shooter game, you gotta be able to know when to press the attack and when to back off. And of course, hide in the ink so you can make an escape. And boom! Launch pad ahoy! You can't hit these shielded ones, okay. Use R to distract them with a bomb, then attack from behind. So yes, you have bombs, which are basically... they're called bombs, but they're basically like the grenades of this game. There are three kinds of bombs you can use in Splatoon single player. One of which is already unlocked, but the other two you have to unlock, later on. So once again, we gotta distract them again. Or I can miss with the bomb. Hey, over here. See ya. And take this guy out as well. Now you can run out of ink. You run out of ink based on, you know, shooting your gun as well as using your bombs and stuff. Simply immerse yourself in the ink in squid form to refill your ink tank. Very, very simple. It's time to feed the fish, bucko! Charge! I wonder if I should go for a Mr. Krabs type voice with Captain Cuttlefish. I don't know, I can't do a good pirate voice. Now, it's not just a matter of getting from one end of the level to the next, although that is clearly the main objective in each stage. There are also certain collectibles you can grab. There's one major collectible in each stage that can be found, and it is this. That is a sea scroll, and there are 27 sea scrolls in the game, one in each stage, and I don't know if you really get anything for collecting them all, but it is, you know, it is nice to collect them for completion. And I will be going for all 27, because they fill you in on the backstory of the game and things like that. You can also collect pieces of armor hidden throughout the stages, and those will allow you to take a few extra hits before you start losing health. Let's go ahead and take this guy out. So we need to find a key to open that vault in order to make some progress, so let's go ahead and find that key, ladies and gentlemen. It's the key to our destiny, and it will be key to getting to the end of the level. Yes, I am very good at bad key puns. I'll be here all night. And there we go. And now we reach the final checkpoint. Now you may be noticing these small orange objects that I'm picking up. I believe these are called power eggs. And how they work is they basically function as your currency in the single player campaign. You're gonna need to collect these little eggs in order to be able to afford to upgrade your equipment. You can upgrade your bombs, you can upgrade your shooter, and you can upgrade your ink capacity. So be sure to collect as many of these little orange things as you can so that you have enough currency to upgrade. You don't necessarily have to upgrade your stuff, but it will make things much easier as you go through the game. And here we go! Zapfish off the port bow! Bust it and grab it! Alright, so here we go. And our first Zapfish has been acquired. Those are the main collectible. They are basically the power stars. You know, since I'm playing Super Mario 64, the Zapfish are basically the power stars of this game, which will allow you to... you have to collect those to make progress. And they're called the Sunken Scrolls, not the Sea Scrolls. I must be thinking of the Dead Sea Scrolls. That's something else entirely different from this game. So anyway, the Sunken Scrolls basically give background on the game. For example, Since time immemorial, a rare type of electric catfish known as the Zapfish has been prized by Inkling society as a source of energy. In fact, the entire city of Inkopolis is powered by a single 100-year-old Great Zapfish. And that's about all we got for now. Nice work on your first mission. I knew you could do it, bucko. Arr. Alright. A pirate never says okie dokie then. A pirate says arr. Yes, I had to make a SpongeBob reference. It was there. Anyway, time for mission number 2, Lair of the Octoballs. Splat your way to the top. And I will be going through the entire first area in this first episode, since it's not that big of an area. And here we go! New type of enemy right there. That enemy will try to chase after you, and I've never let that enemy get close to me, but I'm assuming once it catches up to you, it'll try to explode or something, so keep those guys away from you. Now, in some stages, you'll come across these large... Is this supposed to be some kind of... I guess it's supposed to be some large balloon filled with ink. Shoot it, and it will explode, sending ink all over a large area. So use that if you need to quickly splat an area so that you can keep moving. And it's time to go up. No, you're not getting me today. Now, I will go ahead, I guess, and start addressing the multiplayer component of this game. Even though I have had this game for the past year or so, I have not ever actually played the multiplayer. I've just never gotten around to playing the multiplayer. Maybe I'll play it for the playthrough, like mix up multiplayer and single player just for fun, but I can't necessarily promise anything. If I do the multiplayer, I'm probably going to be lousy at it, but it would probably mix things up a little bit. And again, you know, Splatoon is primarily multiplayer based. The campaign really is there just to help you learn the game mechanics, which you can then utilize to master multiplayer. Maybe I'll try something like, I'll do one day on the weekend will be the one upload will be the single player, and the next upload will be the multiplayer. You know, maybe that will work. If this gets any kind of response at all. I mean, I know I'm not the biggest channel on YouTube, but anyone that does check out this first episode and they enjoy it, let me know what you think if you want to see me tackle the multiplayer as well as the single player. And there's our sunken scroll for level number 2. Now it's just a matter of getting to the end. So you see the Octoball enemies here. These guys will roll around and they will try to leave their ink everywhere to hinder your progress. However, you can bog them down in your ink by shooting at them until they finally get bogged down to the point where they explode and you can just clear the way. Yeah, stick the landing. I love that transition. Now, another type of enemy is this thing. This thing is basically almost like a vacuum cleaner type enemy. It will suck up the ink that you lay down, and you can't, to my knowledge, you can't really do anything to hurt them. So you just have to avoid them and just, you know, keep laying down the ink. Go up here, shoot these balloons. Booyah! Very nice. And up we go. Stick to the wall and then use X to climb faster. I'm not even, like, although again, I'm reluctant to try and jump into the multiplayer because I've never actually done it before. I just know I'm gonna be terrible at it, but like I said, this game focuses on the multiplayer, so I do feel like it wouldn't be right if I did this game and didn't at least look at the multiplayer, you know what I'm saying? And I guess I'll go into kind of what inspired me to play this game. It was actually when I saw the reveal for the Nintendo Switch, the upcoming new console from Nintendo, and one of the games advertised was Splatoon 2. And I don't know why, but that just compelled me to come back and play this game again, and I was like, I was playing it, and I was like, I should do a playthrough for it. So here we are. So now we have the ink cannon, which allows you to launch ink missiles that can basically coat the area in ink. This is a very fun little power-up to mess... Well, not really a power-up. This is a very fun set piece to mess with, although you gotta be careful. So let's go ahead and paint as much of the area in our ink as we can. The problem is that wall down there is being patrolled by that enemy that cleans the ink off, so this is gonna require some work. A good thing to do when dealing with these things is to spray ink in one area, which will distract it, and then you can just, you know, spray ink in another area, and there's our Zapfish. Got it. And we also get a currency bonus for wearing pieces of armor. Very nice. Mission number two done, and here is Sunken Scroll number two. We Octarians dwell in a world deep underground. The individual caves in which we live are connected by a network of transport devices known as kettles. Wow, you learn something new every day. So yeah, so like I said, it adds backstory to the game, and it even gives you backstory on the Octarians and why they're trying to take over Inkopolis and kidnap the Great Zapfish. Now it's time for the final level of the first area, level number 3, Rise of the Octocopters. Leap to victory! Alright, let's see what this is all about. Go ahead and get some more little eggs here from that tree. And now we have a new variation on the Octarian enemies, Octocopters, airborne enemies, that can easily be taken out, but they can be a bit annoying if you allow them to linger for a little too long. Now the meter up at the top left corner of the screen, that basically is, it's interesting, it serves as a health meter, but also a lives counter as well, because basically if you fall off the stage or if you get immersed in enemy ink for too long, you will basically, you'll lose a segment of that life bar and you'll be taken back to a previous checkpoint. So it's both a health bar and a lives counter in a way. Rest up behind a wall if you're hurting. Great advice, Captain Cuttlefish. I'll be sure to take that to heart. And boom. Alright, occasionally you will come across certain power weapons on the maps, and in this case we get the Ink Zooka. So press down the R stick, the right thumbstick, and let loose while you still are able to use it. You can only use your power weapons for a limited amount of time before they are used up, but while you have them, you can really do some damage. Avast! Octocopters below! And now it's gonna be Octocopters gone! Aye! Well done! Arg. If only I could do a pirate voice, I just can't seem to pull it off right now. And there's our sunken scroll for this level, so let's continue our journey. Moving walls, they are no obstacle, considering I can just coat the surface with ink and then swim through it. But trust me, the stages are going to get more, maybe not more intricate, but there are going to be some more challenging stages as we go along. I mean, obviously, we are still in the first area. Sink me! You did it! I don't know if sinking is something you want to do, Captain. Dar she blows! Zapfish, dead ahead! Alright, oh, look out. Yeah, watch yourself when you land in the purple ink. That nasty looking scallywag is an Octo Bomber. Alright, so these guys are a little bit more formidable to deal with than your standard Octarian. These guys will launch bombs at you, basically try to beat you at your own game. And we have ourselves another Inkzooka. I have a feeling I was supposed to use that on the Octobomber, but the regular shooter does a good enough job on its own that I didn't even need it. And the Zapfish is ours! And we get some bonuses for having armor and that special weapon that I didn't actually need to use. Level 3 done! This seems to be an Octarian assault vehicle, but it doesn't appear to have an engine. The big question then, how does it move? It's frighteningly clear that the source of Octarian power lies outside the realm of established science. Interesting. So beating every standard level in a given area will unlock the boss kettle, which will allow you to, well, take on the boss. However, before we do that, I'm actually going to demonstrate how to upgrade your equipment. You can upgrade your hero shot, which is your gun. You can upgrade your ink tank. You can upgrade your splat bombs. And you can buy burst bombs and seekers. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to upgrade my ink tank. Like, I'm primarily going to focus on my ink tank capacity and my hero shot when it comes to upgrading things, but I'll go ahead and buy everything else as well so that we already have it available. Alright. And now we can switch bombs with the control pad, the D-pad. Very nice of the game to point that out to us. And ladies and gentlemen, we are going to go ahead and finish off the first level, or the first area of Splatoon single player. It's time for the boss, Squish Squash Smash, the mighty Octo Stomp. Here we go. Let's do it. Stuck the landing. Nicely done, Inkling. And here we go. Nice to meet you. So this is Octo Stomp. What he'll do is he will try to charge at you, and when he gets up to you, he'll try to slam down on top of you and crush you. Squirt spray ink on his side when he's face down, and then spray the tentacle on top of him to do damage. And now it's on to phase two. In typical Nintendo boss fashion, it takes 3 hits, 1 in each phase, to take down the bosses of this game. And if you're a little too slow trying to get on top of Octostomp, he will get back to his feet. Come on. There we go. And yeah, he's gonna make it a little harder to spray his side. But nonetheless, same strategy as the first phase, and now for the final phase. Now his panels are gonna be moving. That's gonna make things interesting, to say the least. But still same as always, and let's see if we can finish it off. Come on. Gotcha. See ya, Octo Stomp. You've just been stomped. Alright, so you get a sunken scroll, as well as a nice cluster of power eggs for defeating the boss, but also the final Zapfish of the first area. Done and done! The mighty Octo Stomp is no longer mighty. Avast! They have the great Octo weapons on their side. At any rate, good work, Agent 3. Keep it up. It's a long road to the Great Zapfish. Indeed, we are just getting started with this game. But now that we've beaten the first boss, we can now unlock passage to the next area. The gate is open. Let's head to the next area. Alright, so we have cleared out the first area of the Splatoon single player. But if you want to see what the next area is all about, you're going to have to wait until the next video because we are stopping here. That is a wrap on this first episode of the Splatoon playthrough. If you folks liked what you saw here, be sure to like, leave a comment, and tell me what you think. I hope to, as always, make a entertaining playthrough, a good playthrough as always, and hopefully I can do this game justice at least as far as the single player is concerned. And please give me feedback if you would like to see me attempt the multiplayer component of this game as well, like I talked about earlier in the video, perhaps alternate between single player and multiplayer, and, you know, give me some feedback if you want to see me attempt that for the playthrough. But other than that, this is Punk Demon Neo signing out for now. I will see all of you in the next episode.